The country's newly appointed defense chief also bearing more about his plans as he retakes the post. Gibo Teodoro says his focus is reforming the DND.
Ang prioridad ko talaga i-reform yung DND proper nga. Gagatulad ng nasabi ko, no? Na kailangan ito yung makabagong organisasyon na kasi sa bigat ng kanyang responsibilidad. It's high time na yung Department of National Defense as the civilian agency which resource manages and provides services to its 5 agencies, Sean. Usap. Pero merong ang Secretary of Target Away ang ating teritoryo sa kahit ng ating credible detag ng ating kakayahan na ipagtanggol ang ating sarili ay sarili nating usapin. Kung sino man ang ipartner natin, wala nang pakialam yung ibang mga tao dyan.
A Muntinlupa court's decision to deny the bail petition of former Senator Leila De Lima, earning condemnation here and abroad. The court on Wednesday ruled the evidence is strong against De Lima and her co-accused. This despite the dismissal of 2 of the former senator's 3 drug cases. De Lima's allies calling the court's decision a grave injustice. Philippine Senator Risa Ontiveros also condemning the ruling.
Nakakadismaya ang patuloy na pagkakulong ni dating Senador Leila De Lima. Karapatan niya ang isang mabilis na paglilitis gaya ng nakasaad sa ating konstitusyon. Nananawagan ako ng agarang at malinaw na resolusyon tungkol dito. Itigil na ang kabulastugang ito. Tigilan na ang pagpapahirap kay Leila.
U.S. Senator Dick Durbin also weighing in. He calls the court's decision tragic and a sad day for human rights champions in the Philippines. Another U.S. Senator, Ed Markey, says De Lima's continued detention is unjustified. U.S. lawmakers led by Markey visited De Lima in detention last year. For Philippine Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla, the denial of former Senator De Lima's bail petition is all due to her lawyers. Remulla blamed them for not filing a writ of habeas corpus instead, which is a remedy against illegal confinement. He tells De Lima's camp to respect the court's decision.
Sinabi ko na dati and we would not have objected if there is a petition for bail based on humanitarian grounds because siya, after all, 6 years na siya, 6 na taon na siya nag-iintay. Sana yun na lang sinulat nila at nag-intay muna yung kanyang mga abogado, sinabi na namin na hindi namin talaga papalagan kung gano'n ang naging dahilan. Pero mas gusto nila magpasikat ng gano'n eh. O kaya magparinig at magpahiwatig na ang tingin nila eh, kayang-kaya nila yung kaso. Yun ang kanilang desisyon eh.
Taal Volcano's sulfur dioxide emission level is declining. But state volcanologists are saying volcanic tremors and degassing activity are still being recorded in the volcano, which is still under alert level 1.
Kahapon, in fact, the volcano island spewed out steams that are around 2,400 meters high. And yesterday, sulfur dioxide emission medyo bumaba naman from 7,680. The previous day, nagiging 5,780 na lang kahapon.
Meanwhile, VOG or volcanic smog remains a problem for the residents near the volcano in Batangas. The Provincial Disaster Management Office says some people are experiencing runny nose, common colds, and itchiness of throat. The PDRRMO also distributed 10,000 units of N95 masks, which are proven most effective in filtering ash.
Due to the high volume of smog being emitted by Taal Volcano, classes are still suspended in municipalities of Bagoncillo, Balete, Laurel, and Talisa. We still insist that the people should be warned of not going to the island of Taal Volcano, not to be complacent, but be prepared to whatever things might happen when worse comes to worse, individually, by family. And of course, please make sure that they are having their N95 masks when they go out.
The camp of the detained former senator meanwhile slams the Justice Secretary's remarks. Her lawyers assert humanitarian grounds were actually cited in their bail petition.
I just like to also point out that the humanitarian ground was actually part of the petition for bill of the defense of former Senator Dayo de Lima. That's first. And secondly, the fact that she is not also a flight risk was cited by the defense. So I think if the Secretary of Justice will just read through the petition thoroughly, those points were actually cited. And in fact, the court said that even despite the attempt on the life of Senator Dayo de Lima, that particular incident was not even was not taken by the court as enough to actually grant bail on a humanitarian trial. So humanitarian grounds was cited by the defense at the camp of Senator Dayo de Lima.
De Lima's camp also says the bail petition denial is not at all surprising since she's been politically persecuted. Despite the setback, they remain unfazed as they plan to appeal the court's decision.
And Senator Dayo de Lima's camp will exercise the remedies available to her to question the order. We will question the order. We do not want to actually discuss yet to the public what are our possible next moves. But definitely, what I can announce is, of course, we're going to question the motion, the order through a motion for consideration.
The Office of Civil Defense held a simultaneous nationwide earthquake drill this morning. Bianca Dava joins us with that story. Hi, Bianca.
Hi, Stanley. The Office of Civil Defense underscored the need to further prepare communities to mitigate the possible damage that could be caused by a massive quake. The OCD conducted this morning an earthquake drill here in Mandaluyong City. This is also part of the second quarter national simultaneous earthquake drill this year. The scenario, a magnitude 7.2 earthquake, hit Metro Manila. Communities and offices here in the area, as well as participating government officials and personnel, immediately did the duck, cover, and hold after hearing the iconic buzzer. The exercise also included community evacuation, search and rescue in collapsed structures, and mass casualty incidents. The OCD and the NDRRMC said, while the response of authorities and rescue units was commendable, communities' preparedness for the so-called Big One must still be improved. In a study conducted by the OCD, CIVOX, MMDA, and JICA, an estimated 60,000 people in Metro Manila, Central Luzon, and Calabarzon will possibly die if the Big One hits at night. Another 120,000 are projected to go missing. This is why the OCD is also planning to conduct a night earthquake drill to test the preparedness of the public and the response time of night and early morning rescue units. Stanley, the NSED is a quarterly event with the next exercise set in September this year. Stanley?
During the pandemic, a lot of these activities had been put in the back seat, but now that we're back to normal, are earthquake drills going to be more frequent? You said it's once every quarter. And which areas do you think, or have you heard of them planning which areas to conduct more earthquake drills in the near future?
Yes, Stanley, since the pandemic started in 2024, a possible scenario wherein the Big One will hit at night.
And what else can you tell us about participation in the drill? I mean, are you seeing more people joining?
Here at the Greenfield District in Mandaluyong City, and we've seen that only the residents and the businesses here in the area participated in the drills earlier. We have not seen other people like from the other streets participating, but for here, particularly in the Greenfield District area, a lot of people participated earlier also.
All right. On that note, we thank you so much for the update, Bianca Dava. The Philippine Social Welfare Department clarifies one of the requirements for beneficiaries of the food stamp program. The DSWD says the requirement to join government's job-generating programs is per household and not per individual. It adds they must present their TESDA or DOLE certifications during the first year of their inclusion in the program. The agency says the requirement aims to end the culture of dependency on assistance provided by government.
We encourage them na yes, nakatatanggap kayo ng assistance mula sa inyo pong pamahalaan, but then in return, we're asking din naman na tulungan po natin yung ating sarili at the same time para maging pakinabang tayo na miyembro po ng ating society.
Sige.
We want to empower them, Sir Tony, in the future, kasama na sila sa workforce po.